All right, guys, here it is, the new DJI Pocket 2. Now, it's actually been a couple years now since they finally have come out with this one, which is a refresh of the Pocket, which came out, pretty much almost 2 years ago. And I've had the Pocket 2 for the past couple weeks now and really just been taking it out with me daily as I do a lot of my behind-the-scenes stuff as I shoot my videos, just to see how it would be in, you know, in a normal setting. I normally go out with my family. I normally take this with me, whether it be something like this or an action camera with me, to basically document what I'm doing throughout the day. And I think that's what the Pocket is really targeted for, just somebody that wants to use it and have a lot higher quality video production while you're doing some of your daily stuff, as well as someone on the social media side, or if you're like me and also do a lot of things where you're vlogging with it. I do a lot of things behind the scenes. I normally will document everything I'm doing behind the scenes. So something like this or an action camera is really what I like to use, mainly because it's small, compact, and super easy to use. So this video, let's dive into the Pocket 2 new specs, as well as the features and things I really like about it, how it also compares to this one right here, the Osmo Pocket 1. And like I always do, there's always room for improvement. So towards the end of the video, I always talk about some things I'd possibly like to see if they do come out with a version 3. And before we get into it, a quick note, DJI didn't pay me for this video. They just sent me these two units to review, which is the standard Pocket with, you know, the accessories and things like that, and as well as the creator combo. Of course, we're gonna go into more detail of both of these packages in this video. But more importantly for you guys as a viewer, I'm actually gonna be giving away this Pocket 2 right here. So make sure you guys stay tuned to the middle of the video. Talk to you a little bit more about the details of what you're gonna need to do if you wanna win the Pocket 2. And if you guys are new to my channel, my name is Aldrin Nastasio. I do a lot of drone tech tips, tutorials, and product reviews right here on this channel. So if that's something that interests you, please consider subscribing and also hitting that bell to be notified when I post new videos. So if you are familiar with the Osmo Pocket 1, here it is right here. The form factor and pretty much look, build, and feel of the Pocket 2 is pretty much identical to the Pocket 1. Now, some of the highlight features of the Pocket 2, we actually do have a larger sensor. We have this new attachment, which is a little joystick, which I really like, which attaches right here on the very front of the Pocket 2. That's a little new feature that they added. And one of the biggest features of the new Pocket 2 now is this wider field of view on this new camera. And here on the side of the Pocket, we actually have a new power button right here at the very top. And yes, we do have a wrist strap that's attached to the actual camera itself and not to the case. A big enhancement on the Pocket 2 is we actually have 4 microphones all the way around. We have one on the side, the back, the other side, as well as on the front of the camera. And if you're to get something like the Creator Combo, there is a ton of DJI accessories that makes everything really built into the camera now. You have less dongles to deal with, less adapters to deal with. So they included now on the Creator Bundle a lot of these accessories that you're gonna wanna use if you want to use this more of a standalone camera, or you're one of those solo content creators out there that might also need something like external audio. Everything's built into here with a wireless transmitter if you were to go with something like this, which is a Creator Combo. The Pocket 1 does have a 1/2/3 CMOS sensor, while the Pocket 2 is a little bit larger at 1/1.7. Wider field of view on the Pocket 2 at 93 degrees at an f1.8. Osmo Pocket 1 shoots at 12 megapixels and the Pocket 2 shoots at 64 megapixels. We have a little bit better slow motion on the Pocket 2 at 1080p at 240 frames a second. Also, with the microphones, like I mentioned, we have 4 mics all around compared to the Pocket 1, where we only have 2 microphones. And we now have the zoom function or zoom options on the Osmo Pocket 2. We did not have any zoom functions on the Osmo Pocket 1. Now, if you're looking at the Pocket 2, they actually have 2 different setups here. One is the standard Pocket with all the cords, cables, a couple of the adapters, tripod mount here at the very bottom. And then here is the Creator Combo. This is one I actually probably would recommend a little bit more, mainly for a couple reasons. One is the handle, or do-it-all handle, which is a little bit bigger, makes it a little bit easier to hold it in the hand. But the bigger one here is the audio transmitter, a wireless transmitter that they have here in the Creator Combo. Alright, so here I am at IKEA just doing a little audio walking test. How does the audio sound? Of course, you can see a bunch of people around me. This is the built-in microphone. You can actually still hook up a lav mic to it, but this is the built-in mic that has on the transmitter. How does the audio sound? 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Here at IKEA, not sponsored. How does the audio sound?
Now, as a solo content creator, one of the really cool things about this built-in wireless system is that not only am I able to use the mic that they provide you, I'm able also to hook up a lavalier mic to it. So if you wanted to hide this lavalier mic underneath your shirt, or if you wanted to do some sort of interview, you're able to hook up a lavalier mic directly to the transmitter. And of course, it'll be transmitting back to the Osmo Pocket.
Now, when it comes to the form factor of the new Pocket 2, like I mentioned, everything is pretty much exactly the same as the Pocket 1. One of the things that they didn't have before is a quarter 20 at the very bottom here to possibly mount this on a tripod. Now, when you buy it, it actually doesn't have it built into the camera itself, but they do include this little adapter down here that all you have to do is pull off the factory bottom piece, put this adapter on it, and now you have a quarter 20 here at the bottom. Then if you also get the creator combo, you have what they call here the do-it-all handle, which is basically a USB-C plug that goes into here, that you also have the quarter 20 at the bottom to put a tripod, and then you move the USB plug here to the very back. Now, of course, if you want the full experience, you're just gonna hook up your phone to the Pocket 2. That way you're able to see everything in a nice large screen. And also, if you wanted to do some story mode editing, you're able to do that through the phone app. You're not able to do that on the actual camera itself. So you just wanna open up the Mimo app, and if you wanna do any of those little quick story mode edits, you're able to do that straight from here. And of course, if you wanna change all of your settings, your resolution, you're able to do that through the phone or through the Pocket itself. Now, one of the enhancements that they did on the Pocket 2 is a faster startup time compared to the Pocket 1. Now let's jump into the biggest gripe of the Pocket 1, which they fixed now on the Pocket 2, and that was the field of view. Especially, this is marketed as a vlog camera. The Pocket 1 was a very narrow field of view.
All right, so this is how everything looks right now. This is the distance away. I'm actually hand-holding it pretty much a full arm length away. Right here, we have the Pocket 1, and this is the biggest issue that we had with the Pocket 1 was that it is very tight. As you can see here with the Pocket 1, it's pretty much just my head up to right below my neck. And here on the Pocket 2, I'm able to get a lot more. I can see all the way out here, all the way around. So that field of view is a lot wider on the Pocket 2, and I think that was probably one of the biggest drawbacks of the Osmo Pocket number 1 was that field of view. It was, you know, marketed as a vlog camera, but as a vlogger, you definitely want a little bit more background room here. As you can see here with the Pocket 2, definitely have a lot more room if I were to also have somebody else in the shot. I do have face tracking on, shooting at 4K at 30 frames a second. So how does this look? Definitely a big upgrade as far as that field of view goes. That was the one thing that really held me back from using the Pocket 1 a lot more, because of the fact it was just way too tight in there.
Now, the one thing you're able to do with the Pocket 2 that you weren't able to do with the Pocket 1 is zoom in on your subject. And if you're in 4K, you're able to zoom in at 2x, and you can go even further in at 4x if you wanted to bring that resolution down to 1080p. Now, because it is digital zoom and not optical zoom, some people might just say, why don't you just do the zoom in later in post? But honestly, when you shoot with cameras like this, when it is more of an all-purpose type of camera, these are things you don't want to deal with in post. That's the reason why they build it in here. I took this out into the amusement park and I just wanted to just quickly zoom in on some of the animals. It was super easy to do using this joystick right here. You can actually change it from either gimbal movement or gimbal modes to zooming in and out. So it made it super simple just to zoom in on a subject or an animal and then zoom back out. Now, if you wanted to get a little bit more dynamic shots and you want to do some slow motion with the Pocket 2, you are able to do that. You can shoot at 1080p at 240 frames a second, where the Pocket 1 capped out at 1080p at 120. Now, the Pocket 2 does have Active Track 3.0, which is very similar to some of the things that they've had on their previous cameras, as well as their drones. Basically, if you want to be able to set your camera up and have it track or follow a subject, you're able to do that by double-clicking on the subject on the screen itself. Or if you have the Mimo app open, all you have to do is select that subject on the Mimo app, and then it'll automatically start tracking the subject around. I did find out when I was testing between the 1 and the 2, the 2 was definitely a lot better as far as tracking goes, but there were some situations where I found that if the scene is pretty busy or if the subject does not have a lot of contrast with the background, it might lose them. But definitely was a little bit of an enhancement over the Pocket 1 Active Track. So we do have Active Track 3.0 now on the Pocket 2. And also has this mode switch here. The mode switch, you're able to switch it from things like FPV mode, follow mode, as well as tilt lock. So if you wanted to go into FPV mode right here, what it does is that it'll now follow you. The gimbal will actually go and follow whichever angle you're moving it at. Now, if you want to lock the horizon down, you want to go into something like follow mode here. Now, whichever direction I move, the gimbal will then stay straight and the horizon will stay straight. And that's what that three-axis gimbal is really good for. And also, if you want to do something like this, which is move it up and down, you can lock the tilt. So now it'll stay in horizon mode. But if I want to lower my camera down, the camera will still stay pointed forward just like this. This is a really good feature to use if you want to do some rise shots. So if you wanted to have a subject in front of you and rise right above them just like that, really good one to use something like tilt lock. That way your camera stays straight no matter if you're low or if you're coming up high.
Now, while out of the box, the Pocket 2 is wider than the Pocket 1, as you guys saw in my previous test, but they actually give you an extra little wide adapter. So if you wanted to be even wider than how it comes out of camera, you can actually store it inside this little case right here, and it is a little wide adapter, very similar to what you saw some of the aftermarket ones that came out for the Pocket 1. So this gives you an even wider perspective. So here's what it looks like with my arm fully extended out, just out of camera of the Pocket 2. This is how wide it is. Now let's drop on this little magnet extra wide angle right here, and that's how much more or how much wider that field of view is with the adapter on it. So can you guys tell a difference? Should be a little bit wider. This is what it looks like with the adapter on, and then this is what it looks like with the adapter off.
Now, as far as some of the intelligent modes, you do have all the standard one that DJI normally has on all their cameras and all their drones. You have things like the panoramic shots, time lapse, hyperlapse, motion lapse. These are things that are pretty standard now within the DJI applications. So they have all those there on the Pocket 2. One of my favorite modes on the Pocket 2 is that motion lapse. It's really cool to have some sort of motion time lapse that you're able to position the camera at one angle and then end at another angle. And as far as battery life goes, it has been bumped up. You get about 140 minutes, a little over 2 hours of actual use time. And then to charge it up, it's a little bit more than an hour. I think they rated about 70, 73 minutes to charge up the battery. Now, just like the Osmo Pocket 1, the battery is internal, so you're not able to change out the batteries. If you wanted to shoot a lot longer and just swap them out, you do have to charge it up because they do not have a removable battery on the Pocket 2. Now, my overall thoughts on the Pocket 2, super impressed as far as kind of catering to a lot of the issues that a lot of people had, including myself, of the Pocket 1. But as far as some of the improvements go, I just want to talk to you about some of the things that, as I was using it more and more and more, some things I'm like, oh man, I wish I really had this and I wish I had that. And the thing is, they actually have some of these on some of their other devices like the Osmo Action. Now, the first thing I hope they bring over from the Action is this button right here, which is the quick switch button. This is probably still, even when I compare this to something like my GoPro, is the ability to easily quickly switch or quick switch through preset profiles that I pick. Now, next thing I hope they update, possibly on their next version, is some way to lock the gimbal in transport. Now, if I press and hold the off button, of course, it'll then flip and turn just like this. And what you're gonna need to do then is now put it into your case face down just like that, just like this. And then you travel with it like that. It would be nice, very similar to how you see some of the bigger gimbals now, where you're able to lock the gimbal in place. So even if it was some locking mechanism here that I'm able to flip up or switch up, and that would then not only lock the gimbal and lock the camera, it also keeps everything positioned this way. So if I were to put this in my pocket without this, at least I know that there's some sort of locking mechanism here to protect the gimbal. And the next thing I hope they update is this power button. While it's a nice new feature to add a power button to it, the problem is I would always keep accidentally pressing it, whether it be me trying to make some adjustments or I'm putting it back into my case. So if I'm, you know, shutting it down and I'm putting it back in my case just right here, and if you don't put it in the right way, so you want to be able to put that power button down, because if you do have the power button up just like this, I actually would keep accidentally pressing it. Now, when you press it, it'll then try to power on the gimbal, and of course it's being restricted while it's in this case. And the last thing, as far as improvements go, that I like to see on the Pocket 2 would just be to keep consistency because of the fact that these are all DJI products. We have the Osmo Action and the Pocket 2. I'd like to see a little more consistency with the user interface. You know, how the look and feel is, how the icons look, a little more consistency through it, because if you are in the DJI ecosystem, ideally you're gonna want to try to use the camera systems, especially if you're using things like touchscreen. You wanna use them very similarly, and having them do different actions when you're swiping up and down, I'd like to see that improved on some of their upcoming cameras, whether they change this to match this or this one to match this one. So of course, in my videos, I'm just showing you guys my experiences and my feedback of what I've enjoyed and some of the things I definitely would improve on their next version of the Pocket 2. And of course, the links to the Pocket 2 and the Pocket 2 Creator Combo, that'll all be down below in the video description. So if you guys want even more information about the Pocket, make sure you guys check those out. And there it is, guys. Those are my thoughts on the new Pocket 2. Now, just like I talked about in the beginning of the video, I'm gonna be giving this one away. And as you guys know, giveaways on my channel are really simple. First thing, of course, you have to like this video. Make sure you guys are subscribed to this channel. Also, don't forget to turn on the notification bell. That way you don't miss any videos that I do post in the future. And if you're interested in winning this Pocket 2, make sure you guys leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you plan on using the Pocket 2 for. Are you guys like me where you just want to document life? I have a family, 3 kids. I normally don't like missing any moments, so I'm pretty much recording daily. Or do you want to do something just with higher production value in general, possibly real estate, action sports, or anything like that, where you just want really high quality 4K footage? Let me know in the comment section down below what you plan on doing with the Pocket 2. I'll be picking a random comment winner from the comments down below, so make sure you guys get your comments in there, then you can be entered to win the DJI Pocket 2. And as always, guys, if you guys got some value from this video, a big like would be much appreciated. And also, don't forget to subscribe. Hit that bell to be notified when I post new videos. This is Aljustacio with FlightPath.com. I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.